Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Ramesh. In this video, I'm going to discuss about the complete details of two different kinds of photodiode. Those are pin and avalanche photodiode. The photodiode is a one kind of detector. It can able to convert the optical signals into the electrical signals. This is the symbolic representation of the photodiode. Here the arrows is nothing but light, and arrows is coming towards the diode, that it means that light is absorbed by the diode. Photodiode is a semiconductor device and it is operated in reverse bias condition. The complete details about the PN junction photodiode, its construction, working principle is discussed in the previous video. Now, in this video, I'm going to explain the benefits of pin and avalanche photodiode when we compare with the PN junction photodiode. Based on the specific application point of pin and avalanche photodiodes are designed. Pin is designed for the point of high response speed, and avalanche is designed for the point of high sensitivity. For the application, if the response speed plays a major role, we will use the pin photodiode. If sensitivity, then it means that light weak signals, where we have to detect the weak signals, then in that particular application point of view, we use the avalanche photodiode. The working operation of both the types, like a pin and avalanche photodiodes, are same, and it is operated in a reverse bias. Let's discuss the complete details of both types one by one. First, pin photodiode. A PN junction photodiode is made of two layers. One is P and another N-type semiconductor. Whereas pin, the name itself, it has PIN, that is, it has three regions in the construction. One is the P region, and second one is the intrinsic region, third one is the N region. This is a PN and it is the PIN. Here, the doping concentration of the P and N of pin junction is more when you compare with the doping concentration of the P and N of PN junction, and the width of the intrinsic region should be more compared to the space charge region of the PN junction diode. Construction point of view, pin diode, as discussed earlier, pin diode is made of three semiconducting materials, three different layers. The intrinsic layer is sandwiched in between the P and N, and the top layer P thickness is very, very low, around 1 micrometer, and the top layer is protected by the SiO2 layer, in which there is a window for light to shine on the semiconducting material, and this window is coated with the anti-reflecting coating by using the silicon nitride material. With the anti-reflection coating, once the radiation fall on the semiconducting material, this radiation won't reflect back. Each and every photon coming by the radiation, if the energy gap is more than the, energy is more than the energy gap of the PN material, then it can absorb and it can able to create the electron hole pair. Coming to the working point of view, this is a working diagram of the pin photodiode. This is a P, I, N, and it is connected in the reverse bias. That is nothing but P is connected to the negative terminal of the battery, N is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, and electric field is developed across the diode. The strength of the electric field depends upon the strength of the reverse bias voltage. As you keep on increasing the voltage of the pin diode, the depletion region width is also increases. At a particular instant of time, the depletion region covers the complete intrinsic region. Once it covers the complete intrinsic region, there is no free mobile charge carrier takes place in the intrinsic region. all the charge carriers are removed from the intrinsic region. In this condition, there is no electron hole recombination takes place within the depletion region because it is completely free of mobile charge carriers. Once, because of the photon, if it create the electron hole pair, then electron move towards the n side and hole move towards the p side because of the internal electric field. The nature of the electric field is it always carries the positive charge along its direction and negative charge in the opposite direction. The strength of the electric field, if the strength is more, the time taken to move towards the respective regions is also less. That is, very fast it can move towards the p and n region. This is the energy band diagram for the corresponding pin photodiode. This is the p and it is I and it is n. Once the photon, if it is absorbed, photon is more than energy, is more than the energy gap eg value, then it can able to create the electron hole pair. Electron move towards the n side and hole move towards the p side. Coming to the switching speed, the switching speed of a photodiode is a key parameter that defines the response time of an overall system. Switching speed is it depends on the response time of overall system. So switching speed is depends upon the minority carrier lifetime of the system. If the minority carrier lifetime is more, switching speed is less. If the minority carrier lifetime is low, switching speed is more. That means switching speed is inversely proportional to the minority carrier lifetime. In case of pin photodiode, that is that too, where the speed of response is important, the depletion region which should be made as large as possible to create the small minority carrier lifetime. As a result, the switching speed also increases. This is possible by increasing the intrinsic region in the pin photodiode. Pin photodiode uses and advantages point of view. It is used in various applications because of its specific properties. That is, it can be used as high voltage rectifier. That is, it can able to tolerate maximum voltage because of the intrinsic region provides in between the P and N region. And coming to the RF switch, that is, it can increase the level of isolation when the diode is reverse biased. And the capacitance between the regions is also decreases because the capacitance is inversely proportional to the separation between the two regions. Here, because of the intrinsic layer placed between the P and N region, the capacitance across the junction is also decreases. And coming to the third application, that is photodetector. When you compare with the PN junction, the conversion efficiency of light into the electrical signals is more in case of pin photodiode because there is no recombination takes place in the intrinsic region. So these are the general applications of pin diode, high voltage rectifier, RF switch, photodetector. And coming to this second kind of photodiode, that is avalanche photodiode. Before explaining the avalanche photodiode, I am going to explain the what is the conditions for the avalanche breakdown. Here, this is the PN junction diode and it is connected in the reverse bias. P is connected to the negative terminal of the battery and N is connected to the positive terminal of the battery. This is the depletion region. When the light enters into the depletion region, if the light energy is more than the energy band gap, then it creates the electron hole pair. And in addition, electric field strength is also more because high reverse voltage is applied. Once if you apply the high reverse voltage, the electric field across the diode is also more. Because of the high electric field, it gains, like electron hole gains more velocity. With that velocity, it accelerates to and fro. Then obviously it collides with the rest atoms of the depletion region. Then it can able to create the new electrons, like it can be able to release the electron from the atom, then electron moves to the conduction band from the valence band, then it can be able to create the new electron and hole pairs. So see the current and voltage characteristics point of view. Initially, up to a particular voltage, there is a minute current. That current is called as leakage current due to the minority charge carriers. When it reached to a particular voltage, the electron, like a charge carriers, number is keep on increases because of the creation of the more number of electron hole pair. Then the current is drastically changes when it reached to a particular voltage. That voltage is called as breakdown voltage, and this condition is called as avalanche breakdown condition. And it is possible by applying the high reverse voltage. The velocity of the minority charge carrier crossing the depletion region increases due to the generated electric field across the depletion region. And these carriers collide with the atoms of the crystal. Because of the violent collision, the charge carrier takes out the electron from the atom. Coming to the avalanche photodiode point of view, avalanche photodiode are high sensitivity and high speed semiconductor detector. So when you compare with the PIN and PN junction photodiodes, avalanche photodiodes are high sensitivity and high speed detection nature. And avalanche photodiode structural configuration is similar to the PIN photodiode. That means it also consists of three regions, P, I, N. But what is the difference when you compare with the PIN point of view? So the difference compared to the PIN is, here the avalanche photodiode operates under a high reverse bias condition, that is around avalanche breakdown condition. The electron hole pairs that are generated by the incident photons are accelerated by high electric field, and it kick the new electron from the valence band to the conduction band. So that means the incident photon create the one electron hole pair. These electrons and holes within the intrinsic region accelerated due to the electric field, and it hit the rest atom, then it can able to create the new electrons and hole pair. That means the number is keep on increases, that is nothing but internal gain takes place. These are swept out of the depletion region or intrinsic region quickly due to the low transit time, and it is possible because of the high electric field. So the current sensitivity is increases from 30 to 100 times due to its avalanche operation, because more charge carriers are created at that particular condition. Because of that, the current is drastically changes due to the internal gain. The sensitivity is increases around 30 to 100 times due to avalanche operation. Coming to the avalanche photodiode uses and its advantages point of view, because of its high sensitivity and high speed nature, it can be used in measurement of distance, data transmission, high speed industrial inspection, and various medical and scientific instrumentation. This is the general information related to the PIN and avalanche photodiode. In case of PIN, the response speed is more, whereas in case of avalanche point of view, sensitivity is more. Thank you. Thanks for watching.